Hello everybody. Got a slightly different background today. If you haven't been here before, my name is Debbie and I read a lot of books, which is why I thought I'd do a what I am currently reading. If you've been here before, you'll know that I can read quite a few books at the same time. I've just got one of those brains where I just find myself reading a lot. And to be fair, they're all quite different books, which is how my brain stays in my head, basically. If I'm reading books that are really similar to each other, I find that difficult. But if I'm reading books that are in kind of slightly different genres and have very different types of stories, I find it much easier to read multiple books at a time. So I've got a pile of books. I say a pile, it's a few physical books that I'm currently reading, plus a book that I am reading on BorrowBox, the library app, and also what I am currently reading on the Kindle app. So I'm going to go with the physical books I actually have to hand, and I'll finish with my most anticipated book, which is a book that has recently arrived that I ordered, and basically I'm very much looking forward to reading it. So yeah, the first book I'm going to show you is Call of the Penguins. So I literally just finished editing the video for the book before this. So the first one is Away with the Penguins. So this is one that's of the series Sunday Group, and this is Call of the Penguins by Hazel Pryor. This is book number 2, and as you can see, I have just started it. I'm on page 56, which is chapter 9, so I'm very much looking forward to seeing where this goes. Alright, I have also started The Bullet That Missed by Richard Osman. When I'm reading this at home, especially if it's going to end up going into a bag, I like to take the dust jacket off, which is why this has been exposed to the elements. But I will say, this is the first book I've ever owned that's had printing on the side, and I think it's absolutely amazing. But also, look at those end pages! Aren't they beautiful? Yeah, so I've only just started it. You can see where my little magnetic bookmark is. Yeah, I'm one chapter in. One chapter. But I'm very much looking forward. Is this book number 3? Deb's pop a note to let people know which book number it is. And then the next big physical book, I'll admit it's a little bit dusty, is because of where it sits. So, this is a Mahusive book. It's the Harry Potter page to screen. Now, I am somebody who loves looking at behind the scenes stuff. I love looking at trivia. As you can see, this book is massive. It is bigger than my head. I think if I stand up next to it, this book comes to just under my knee. That is how big this book is. It might not look like I'm very far into it, but I think I'm quite a few pages in. More than you think. I'm about 50 pages in, but yeah, this basically goes through the making of all of them. It's just amazing. But yeah, the complete filmmaking journey of making the films. So, as somebody who grew up reading the books and watching the films, just seeing behind the scenes of how these films were made is just so interesting to me. This was a gift years and years and years ago. It feels, I'm not quite sure when this was published. It's just got some great pictures, behind the scenes stuff. Things that like fold out, it's incredible. Let's see if I can actually get this in. So, you got a complete fold out of the entire main cast. Isn't that amazing? And I just love how you got all these dark robes and then you've got the evil pink woman. Yes, I think the entire Harry Potter fandom can agree that Umbridge is worse than Voldemort, because we all have that teacher at school that we hated. The next one that I am reading is The Library of the Lost and Found by Phaedra Patrick. I read a different book by Phaedra Patrick not that long ago, and I was completely obsessed with it. And that was The Bookshare. I really enjoy The Bookshare, but now I'm on to The Library of Lost and Found. So it's that one there. That's the one that I'm reading at the moment. I have 20 days to read it, and where am I? I've just started chapter 6, page 62, so you can tell that I've started a few books at the same time here. But I'm already liking this book, and I'm very interested to see where it goes. And then on my Kindle app, I am reading the Jessie Hunt series by Blake Pierce. So you can see I've got 19 books of Perfect Wife. And then the one next to it is The Unstoppable with Beaufort books, which was the, I say prequel, it was written first, I've just gone backwards to read Liv because I didn't read Liv, I jumped straight in with Sophia. So yeah, and then my most anticipated book of books that I have got to read, this one, I was listening to a podcast on a walk at work the other day and it made me think about my favourite biographies, and to be honest, I've read a few celebrity biographies and I do enjoy reading them, finding about people's history and how they got into the entertainment business. I've got John Barrowman's, I've got Joe Brand's, I've got Michael McIntyre's, I've got Lenny Henry's, I've got Jennifer Saunders and Dawn French. And yeah, when I was thinking about like who was the biography that I always wanted but never got because she passed away, Victoria Wood. And I seemed to remember some rumblings about talks that she was getting ready to write her biography before she passed away. So then I googled it, and unbeknownst to me, somehow I missed it in amongst the crazy world that was 2020, that there was a man called Jasper Rees who probably interviewed Victoria Wood the most. And after Victoria had passed away, he was given permission by the estate to go into Victoria Wood's archives, speak to her family, speak to her friends, and write what is essentially her authorised biography. So this arrived yesterday and I cannot wait to read it. It's called Let's Do It, the authorised biography of Victoria Wood. It is massive, it's got loads of pictures in there which I am very much looking forward to having a look through. I have been obsessed with Victoria Wood for years. She's a comedian that I grew up watching. I thank my mum and dad for my obsession with Victoria Wood, from like everything she's done, everything she's written, whether it's like the sketch shows, her friendship with obviously with there being like Wood and Walters, her friendship with Julie Walters, and Dinner Ladies is probably one of the best sitcoms in the world. I adored Dinner Ladies and still do adore Dinner Ladies. It's one of those ones that even though there's only two seasons, I can watch episodes of Dinner Ladies and there's always something new. Because it was so jam-packed, there are so many jokes that might have gone over my head years ago that I can now rewatch and go, oh, I get that now. So yeah, this is what it looks like with the dust jacket off. It's very simple. I love the gold foils across the side. This is a very welcome addition to the bookshelf, which I will never get rid of. The fact that we can't get a book written by Victoria Wood, this is the closest that we'll ever get. Can you feel me getting emotional? I was so upset when Victoria Wood passed away. I remember coming home from work that day. My mum looked at me and went, "You've not heard." And I was just like, "I haven't heard what?" And she was just like, "Victoria Wood passed away from cancer today." And I remember I just went to my red room and cried, because she was one of those people for me who I just admired so much. Why am I getting emotional? I think it's just because she was always the person, she always has been and always will be the person that I always thought that if I ever got to meet her, she would be the one who I'd be fully starstruck for. Fortunately, I do know people who have worked with her and they said that she was a perfectionist, which I'm not surprised by, and that she was very serious when it was her own work. I have heard interesting stories about her work on Housewife 49 and how kind of like she was so in the zone, and to be honest, I think some people might think of that as just like, oh, she was just ignoring everybody, but it was like, no, she wrote it, she was a producer. I can understand her tunnel vision there. So yeah, but generally the main consensus from people I know who have met or worked with her was that she was just, as I said, she was a perfectionist, but she was so supportive to the people around her, and that just warms my heart to know that I do know people that work with her. The stories that I have heard live up to the person who I always thought she was. So yeah, so those are the books that I am reading, and the book that arrived recently that I didn't know existed until a couple of days ago, and I am so glad I discovered it and found it. and I am just going to savour this book forever. No matter what, this is a book that's always going to be in my bookshelf, because Victoria Wood, I've always said, she's one of those people whose career I just looked up to so much, as a singer, as a performer, as a writer, as a comedian. She was just absolutely incredible, and now I want to go and binge watch all of her stand-ups again, because I've got pretty much all of them. I haven't got all of our scene on TV, or do I? Everything's on DVD. And there's only one DVD player in the house, so when I have my own place, I'll have to get like an external CD slot for my computer so that I can watch everything. But yeah, just her stand-ups are just a thing of genius, and I just need to rewatch everything. Watch me getting emotional in a book about what I'm currently reading. But yeah, this one I think is going to be one that I will savour and read slowly and devour every single word, because I mean, looking at this, it's like my parents know that this is a book that I could probably read quite quickly. 546 pages, that includes the acknowledgements. For the full book without like the sources, acknowledgements and everything, it's 506 pages. So yeah, this book completely has my heart, it really does. So you've got a little inside of my brain at the moment. I might as well go into what's currently reserved. So on BorrowBox, the library app, on my reserves, I've got The Last to Vanish by Megan Miranda. And then in the reserved section, I've got The Memory Police by Yoko Ogawa. I've heard quite a lot about this book. I think I'm a bit late on the train for this book, and considering the fact that I think it was originally written in like the 80s, it was adapted and translated a few years ago, and I've heard quite interesting things about it. So, but I won't actually have access to this until September from the looks of things. It might come out a little bit sooner than that, but at the moment it says at the 10th of September. But I have had experiences where books turn up a bit earlier on BorrowBox, so we'll see. And then on Kindle, recent editions include My Dark Vanessa. That's another one I heard on a bookcast that I thought was sounded quite interesting. And I've got some other Blake Pierce books on here, plus some classics, including like Wuthering Heights and stuff. So I'm trying to make it a point to read a few more classics in regards to stuff like Shakespeare and just stuff that I know that I haven't read that I feel like I should have read. I think at some point I might just have to go through books that I have read which were like pre-YouTube. So I might sort that out once I've organised all my books in regards to like moving and things. But I am in the process of house hunting at the moment, or flat hunting, and so at some point I will have to organise stuff. But yeah, so thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you like the content that I'm making and you want to see more. And yeah, I'll see you next time with another video. Stay safe, everybody. Love you.